guns cocked. Yeah. And you don't stop. We're making hot, nigga. What? Bring it up, blow your whole spot. Yeah. And you don't stop. It's still 187 on an undercover guy. So-
I gave you fair warning, beware, beware, beware. I gave you fair warning, beware, beware.
What you thought plug shit was sweet, now you can't sleep. Gotta keep your eyes open wide and hide your face from the streets. I'm like the beast with a warrant, far from a normal. Gave you fair warning, now you wanna stand squalling. Calling out any rapper that I doubt, smack him in the mouth, throw him in the yoke, boom, then I knock him out. No doubt, Freddy Fox foul, 20 shot, auto Glock cloud, Benny Blanc, Porter Rock style, with a twist of black in the brow, twist your cap in the mouth, sleep with the fish, ditch for yapping from now. What's happening now? Niggas is hard as hell, but they gargamel. Sticking on the smallest victim, gives them heart to kill. My squad is real and holds it down the hardest, regardless. What size of the largest, we polish the floor with the rawest hardcore artists. Flawless victory, and niggas can't do shit to me, physically, lyrically, hypothetically. Realistically, you're the epitome of catch a breath. Catch it when you cash a check. Smash it when you pass the shack for your fucking Lex. Nothing less than the best of the squad did it. Hard-headed niggas better beware of fear like God said it.
I gave you fair warning. Beware, beware.
Yo, I warned you, no more niggas can do is warn you. I'm born to kill, I'm still thrilled, I put it on you. There's no regrets, remorse only results in loneliness.
This is...
You can catch me in the cherry red 150. Ooh. Got the grizzly locked in the stizzy. Pop a glizzy going 60 down a one whizzy. Drunk pissy, trying to cruise through the avenue while my people's just popping bottles up as soon as my neighbor. Fuck that. Spun the UE, lost the hubcap, was back to the shack. Came back and I watched that. Chicks from Paris, chicken Debbie's baby, baby carriage, cherry yellows. Bird, cherry radish, fresh out the dealer. Got the check for the squealers, wear a vest for the killers. Nothing less causes real up in the Big Apple. Quick to get your shit tackled, enemies spit at your best friends, kidnap you, trust no one. Got beef, buzz, yoga, yeah. You don't need no one. Nope. Talking about that you owe him, I'ma go for dolo. Scarface, what up, and dolo, one deep, five is solo, but deep, throwing bolo. It's hard work, baby. I just lost 100 pounds, I'm trying to live. I ain't going nowhere.
Like
I'm staying alive,
they
baby.
Bust, they
guns,
and it's so
wrong. That's my wife, I pay for them bitties. Get your own, dog, you heard?
Niggas wanna fuck my wife. Niggas wanna take my life. But it's so hard.
I'm with the squad, we like dogs. Got this at the bar, the bar, the bar. Yeah. Strip bars in Miami. Almost came home with the Grammy. Next year, bring your home three for the family. Watch me, you can catch a dive on Hitachi. Poppin' shit like a Nazi. Iced out like DiBiase. Fuck that, Liberace. Pro X Versace. Somebody stop me.
Fuck the frail shit. Cause when my coat come in, they gotta use the scale that they weigh the whales with.
Parsons on the cheap, Bugatti made the prototype. Hope you get the picture, but you just can't photo light.
Determined niggas make it, kicking down the door and we burning niggas naked.
The house costs a million, sitting on the beach. And the only thing I know with this furnish, I'ma take it.
My bathtub lift up, my walls do a 360. We got the shit that the government got. Talking money, then you rubbing the spot.
Real niggas say that they be wild. We on the Cayman Islands, on the yacht with our favorite albums.
A bad hole in a plate of salmon. Smoking and drinking, nigga, is you thinking that our fate is violent?
I love my nigga for the fact that he real. And the body on the back will be square.
What? And if you facing capital pun, pass me a gun. And I'ma give you time to run while I rapidly pill. We gon' make it. I learned the game quickly, and I don't like the rent. So when I fly now, I bring my cars on the plane with me. In this case, who's the loser?
Ran through enough coke for Castro to build schools in Cuba. Teach your kids how to read and write and use the Ruger.
Motherfucking niggas is back. G
Jada and P. We got water,
X Haze,
plus way to the D. And I'm tired of hearing about old niggas that had it and be the same old niggas that ratted. Who cares? Let's talk about how we haul niggas and they fucking back.
Gun works official, but niggas don't be wanting that.
Why?
Cause they puss and they mans is lame.
So for real in the hood, we make candy rain.
I could easily send you to God,
but come and see me at the Plaza Hotel. I might give you a job. If you can't remember the name, all you gotta do is ask the dame for the niggas that deliver it hard. We gon' make it. 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 We gon' make it.
Yeah, you know what it is. It's Young Busy, the Kid Busy, Bone, Bone Thugs and Harmony Representative, SD World Vision. Y'all know what it is. Yeah.
Juzz Roc The Mic, and it is ladies' night. Listen, it's Latasha and Elle. Elle got her sexy voice on right now.
Oh yeah.
But it's ladies' night, so we definitely want to hear from all the girls and all the nosy boys that are listening in too. We want to hear from everybody that's rocking with us right now. Juzz Roc The Mic. Let's start off. Firstly, we just had a showcase this past. What was it? Wednesday? I don't even remember what, I don't even know what day it is. It was Wednesday.
We just had our showcase. Today was December.
And it was my first time. It was my first time going, so I'm proud to Juzz Roc The Mic for doing that one. That was a good show. and as usual, Chemistry would start off with putting some people on blast about that showcase. So let's just keep it in good Juzz Roc The Mic spirit and start shouting people out. We're gonna start off with Stam. We got Kenny Dub. We got Track Dealers, and last but not least, Mr. Kane, who is a notorious no-show to all the Juzz Roc The Mic showcases.
I guess he's scared of the mic. Oh.
I don't know what that's about. Mr. Kane, what's up? Like, you can't just be hitting people up, I'ma come, and you never there. Like, that's kind of whack. Shots fired for you.
His name sounds a little scary, Mr. Kane.
I wonder what he does with that cane. What's up with that? I don't know. Well, we ain't worried about him. Y'all all on blast. Y'all stood us up. Y'all didn't come through. But to talk about the highlights, I stayed for a couple of acts because, you know, I don't know. I had things to do. But I'm just saying, I stayed for a couple of acts. And shout out to Miss Lydia Caesar, who I was sad could not be here today. I was trying to get her in here for an interview. She came in with the full curls and the body twisted like a letter S and a short little miniskirt. The boys was loving Miss Lydia Caesar.
Crazy.
Yes. She hit the stage and, like, jaws dropped. Like, they wanted her. I forget who the kid's name was. Oh, Mike Sucks. Was that his name? The rapper that... Mouse Sucks. Mouse Sucks, as soon as he got up on stage after Lydia Caesar, he kind of he gave her a backwards compliment. He goes, "You look like my seventh grade teacher." And she didn't know what that meant.
Sucks.
I don't know. She kind of gave me a side eye, like, really, why is this little boy talking
about me?
He sucks
for that little comment he made.
He was a disco dancer.
I don't know. He was trying, but you kind of missed the compliment on that one. Mouse Sucks. But you were a good rapper, though. Everybody got up there freestyle. Like, the whole audience, Chemistry starts off the showcase with, like, anybody who's a rapper or artist could get up there and do like a little freestyle. The entire audience got in line to do a freestyle before the showcase even started. Like, everybody's perform. Everybody was performing for everybody else.
Freestyle battle.
Right.
Some New York City went down at Recoup Lounge.
You know, some people were dope, and then some people were
not.
I mean, it's the way of the game. You know what I mean? It's how it goes. You know, everybody's not going to be good. But
okay, I've been here. Okay, what was his name? Dead Mouse, Mouse Trap, Mouse Sad Mouse. Yeah, what's
he
up with rappers' names
dancer.
And the meanings behind them? You know.
I think
it's
kind of like
Big Daddy Kane and the KRS-One, and they all had a meaning behind them, and then now, not so much. You have Flo Rida, and
Big Porque, he is from Florida.
Little B, who's a pretty bitch. So
I don't. I think he's kind of working it like Drake. Like, okay, Drake says I'm sensitive, I'm a loser, I drink wine, and he kind of made it cool. So you can't tease him and say Mouse sucks because Mouse sucks. Like, yeah, that's his name.
You just gonna have to come on here somehow and just explain this one, bro. I'm sorry, but
maybe
I'm not
he might could get up here. But Lydia Caesar ain't didn't feel that compliment, so I might have to make you wait a little bit. My girl goes first.
Right.
Anyway, did anyone know how special December 1st is? I see nobody's wearing
my
red today.
My cousin's birthday.
Well, that's an unfortunate birthday. You want to know why? Today is World AIDS Day. Did you know that?
Well, he couldn't help the fact that he happened to be born HIV and AIDS negative on, I'm not going that way. Mm-mm. But I'm not. It's not his fault. That's just not his fault, though, Latasha.
At least he was born healthy. We can say that.
We'll see. He'll come in. He can come show the papers.
I know. But everybody's supposed to be wearing red because it's World AIDS Day. So if you're unsure at this point in your life, please go out and go get tested. And don't spread that monster up amongst the land.
I'll wipe it out like famine.
PSA from Juzz Roc The Mic Radio. Anyway, let's get into some hot topics. Can we talk about all the stuff that was happening that has nothing to do with our lives, but are pretty interesting to watch? Let's see. Did you see the Instagram photo that Rihanna posted with her and Chris Brown?
How about I knew you was going to bring that up? And
let's just start off the show with
about,
that.
I mean, like, it's there. It's out there. The only, I mean, and it's just there. I mean, like, it's Chris Brown, it's Rihanna, it's something that we already friggin' knew. So,
I mean, I understand
they just don't care. They even put out a song about it. It ain't nobody's business, even though that I don't care. I don't care what you say. Fuck the world. That they put out that song, and you know, from then on, it's just Chris and Rihanna. And I feel so sorry for Kara Choo Choo Train. I really do.
I'm sorry. What was her name?
Cuckadoo?
Cuckoo Bee? Cuckoo Cocoa Puffs?
Mm. I feel like honey bunches of oats. I'm going to just call you that. I feel horrible. I know she said, oh, I heard she actually liked the photo.
She did. Ain't that some ish?
No,
right
it was
there.
The one of Chris Brown laying, you know, without a shirt on.
Chris
down.
Brown laying shirtless in Rihanna's bed, knocked out, looking like he got some of that good and couldn't hang. And she liked the picture. I don't know what kind of three-way love is happening, but I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying seeing this unfold.
Yeah, since we have nothing else better to do in our lives. But
that's what Instagram's for.
Right.
Time wasting. Anyway, but I wanted to say, though, the picture that Rihanna was hugging Chris Brown, her caption was, oh, I don't want to leave. You killed it tonight, baby. And she's hugging him. If you kind of look at the body language, it's kind of like she's working mad hard for Chris Brown. Like, he kind of got his head down. He ain't holding her back. He ain't looking at her. It's kind of like she just kind of draping herself over him. And, like, the whole body language on that is just all wrong. Like, I'm rooting for them. I am. And I hope he keeps his hands off of her and vice versa because, you know, she's from Barbados.
Yes,
so they get it popping, too.
Domestic violence on this show.
Both accounts. But I'm kind of rooting for them. So, I don't know. It doesn't look like he's quite set on Rihanna. And while Carrie Cuckoo Train is still liking their pictures, it looks like he still got both hanging on. So,
in other nonsense, but maybe it could be irrelevant news. Black China, Tiger's girlfriend, slash baby mom, slash jump off, slash I'm not wifey yet, but hopefully it'll happen one day if I keep twerking hard enough. From YMCMB or whoever, she, you know, recently had a baby and she's getting back down, you know, to her baby weight, as I saw on a couple of blogs and media sites. But she was wearing, you know, a nice little tight black dress and whatever, and they kind of did a close up on her backside, which, you know, since she used to be a stripper, and, you know, the fat nowadays, yes, the inflatable pen cups, so they were deflated. So
she got flat cakes.
No, it was like a lot of lumpy cakes.
Lumpy cakes.
Let's just,
you know,
call
what?
Them.
That
brings me to that subject of why. I wonder how everything's going to be in 20 to 30 years. See, I know everything's gone. I don't have to worry about me, because people like that it's quick to have fake shit, or fake T's, fake A's, all of that. They come to me like, well, how are you going to look in 60 years? Not like you. I mean, you know, but I can guarantee you that
she looked like that now, though, and she's really young, and she paid for that body, and she looks like that. You might as well have just kept it natural and be naturally
right. And at 16, I've recently seen a picture of her at 16. She was gorgeous, naturally beautiful, not no baby bob eyelashes, and I can't stand that shit. I'm sorry.
Listen, ain't nobody gonna give you a tip drill for being natural, okay?
And nobody's gonna barely give you a dollar looking like Baby Bob from Barney, or that little elephant from Sesame Street with the long eyelashes.
Snuffleupagus.
Snuffleupagus.
You OD.
I did. Jimi Hendrix, rest in peace. His birthday was recent birthday. Rest in peace, Jimmy.
Rest in peace, Jimi Hendrix. I don't know where that
purple
came from.
A's. Okay, I know.
I kind of got my life from Black China, though, because I don't know. Some of the strippers, they, you know, they're entertaining to watch, and I think she's one of them. Her and Amber Rose are entertaining. Rosa Acosta's kind of, she did the Omarion video. Ooh. She lost points for that. You don't know Rosa Acosta?
Oh, yeah. No. Yeah,
but she did the Omarion video, and I was like,
I always say who to have her relevant for people, you know, or maybe that could be there, but they're still not relevant.
Oh, Omarion thinks he's very relevant right now. Did you hear his comment on he's about to hit that Beyonce Crazy in Love, Michael Jackson Thriller stage when they're about to cross over into superstardom? That's where he thinks he is right now.
He should have did that 10 years ago. He's been in the game like 30 years already.
He just signed to MMG. I want to see what kind of Crazy in Love Thriller switch off comes out from MMG.
It's always the people who were previously signed to other, you know, labels and aren't doing so well in life, or, you know, like Bow Wow, for instance, signed to YMCMB. I guess he got long money, he can deal with it, good. And then you have, you know, the Namarion MMG. It's like, oh, maybe if I sign with these cats, things will look up. I could do the Thriller. I can moonwalk into stardom, superstardom.
Somebody
which you should
have
done literally 10 years ago. I'm just saying.
I don't know. I'm rooting for you, Omarion. I'm rooting for you and Sierra, who just can't quite latch on to music and grasp our attention. I'm still rooting for y'all. I'm waiting, though. Y'all taking a long time. You know who's gangster this week? Lindsay Lohan. She punched somebody in the face at Avenue last weekend.
Yeah.
Now there's
back
a lot
to
of
she goes. Someone could just put her in jail for less than 2 minutes and give her more than a pack of ramen noodles and just throw away the freaking key. Somebody needs to give her a sandwich while she's at it. Really, I know how y'all feed people, I guess, in jail, but really give her a couple of sandwiches so she can gain her parent trap weight gain back. She needs
her parent trap talent back.
That's what she needs.
It's just some people, it's not fair that like they continuously fail. And I don't know if it's the media, I don't know if it's their fans, I don't know who it is, but they keep giving them more and more chances. Like, can Lindsay Lohan be over? Can she be done? Can she be out?
I actually seen the Liz, and I turned.
Have
Liz
you watched it?
Yeah, and I turned. No, I turned after like a minute and a half.
She's okay. literally spitting out her lines. There's like no emotion. There's no connection. And this is a legend she's supposed to be portraying. Like, I wonder how offended Miss Elizabeth
Taylor is. She's
rolling
over and doing backflips in her grave right now. She truly is. Rest in peace, Liz. Diamonds are forever. Sierra Leone.
Anyway, it's ladies' night, and I want something a little sexy played right now just to break it up a little bit. Can we start off with some, let's just give some shout-outs, some more love to Lydia Caesar, who did come to our showcase, and, I'm sorry.
Yeah, what was that, Latasha?
That was a brain fail. See, chemistry thinks I have good eyes, so he shows me these tiny little notes from across the room and thinks that I can read them, but he's still getting to know me. He'll know that I am blind as a bat. So.
Just throw it.
Can we just start the music? We're going to shout you out after it's played because I can't see what chemistry is trying to tell me. Ladies night. Woo, Juzz Roc The Mic.
Ha.
Big letter.
This is a Zoom mix. Zoom it down. Ha.
You're the finest girl I see.
So tight, ass looking so mean, but your legs looking lonely. You should let me get in between, cause I've never seen a girl as fine like you. Wake up every morning, get up on the grind like you. Virgo, I ain't never had a sign like you. Princess cut diamonds, they don't even shine like you. I've been all around the world, I've seen a lot of girls, but none of them was like you. None of them was like you. Always on my mind. One day you'll be mine, cause I really like you. One day I might like you. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen. Yeah, you know me.
She the finest thing that I've seen. Turning in half when she hit that scene. Pretty face with a teeny mini waist. Got the dum dum dummy poking out them jeans. She the girl of my dreams. Super freak and a sign of sin. She shorty bad, don't mean to brag, but she got that good pussy kind of swag. Make a nigga go bananas with it. Body thick when I'm swinging stick. Too legit to quit throwing hammer in it. Fix her body so nice. Ass so dumb but her brain so bright. Yeah, her sex need anger management. Like why your pussy so tight? My ride or die, yeah, she by my side. And she rep the set like zoo. And it's crazy sex when she hot and wet. And them sound effects is like ooh. Ain't scared, yeah, that's my boo. Might make me say I do. Yeah, that's my type when I lay that. She coming twice, call it deja vu. Swag.
All around the world, I see a lot of girls, but none of them was like you. None of them was like you. Always on my mind. One day you'll be mine. Cause I really like you. One day I might like you. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen. You don't need no Maybelline. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen. You're the finest girl I seen.
Who is that?
Finest girl that I seen. Baddest girl that I want. She keep it real with me, hold it still for me every time I got caught. Yeah, told her homie she a jump. Damn. He replied she too thick. I like my fluffy with a little bit of buffy and stuffy. I open up with this dick. Then grind, wine, digging in it. Love it when I put my rhythm with it. Baby, you can come on, I don't want to small talk, I just want to get in your rhythms with it. So tell me what you want to do, baby, how you want to move. Cause you look like the wifey type, let's see just what that life is like. She do a thing she never done, all that means is she's having fun. Yeah, I remember last time, my favorite pastime turned her out, now she runs. Baby girl, I'm not done, get your buns to the sun. When I'm tired, get guns.
First time I saw Dim, she had me in a daze. Me and her had a connection like an interphase. So I had to go in like an inner page. Hey sweetie, how you doing, miss? What's your name? She replied, you go boy, spit your game. Can I walk with you, ma, if it's okay? She said she not looking for a lot of things, just a straight up brother with some kind of brains. I told her, you can call me Honest Abe. And right now I'm in love with your model frame. You shot my heart down, bada boom, bada bang. Forget a dime, you about a dollar, right? Know you sick and tired, how them brothers try to holler, right? Not the suit and collar type, nor the boony drama hype. Achieving my goal, I'm living that Obama life. She said, damn, baby boy, we a lot
of
life.
Baby, can I call you if that's alright? Anywhere you are, baby, I'll catch flights. I'm loving the features that you were born with. Whenever you need love, trust me, I'm on it. Tell me, can you see you with me? Cause baby, I want you. I want you, I want you.
Shorty rock, light skin, walking on the block. Should I holler? She hotter than the coffee top. I'm in the whip, smell like piff, but I'm hawking my. Drove up and I asked her, why you walking by? She said, what? I said, angel soaring fly. She said, tough. I said, I'm an awesome guy. Of course I'm fly. Lifestyle went poor, I grind. Parked up, then I G-strode to her side. Shoot me down? Yes, this is suicide. We converse about diverse news in life. She a nurse, I want the hospital tonight. Feeling sick, a cheap super, do me right. Now usually foolish me be moving right. Other brothers try to cuff her, said she bougie, right? I said, yeah, but she do me right. Cool as Kool-Aid and bootlegs for movie night.
Baby, can I call you if that's alright? Anywhere you are, baby, I catch flights. I'm loving the features that you were born with. Whenever you need love, trust me, I'm on it. Tell me, can you see you with me? Cause baby, I want you, I want you, I want you.
Just give me a chance, girl. So I can fulfill your every need, baby. Guaranteed to make you my lady. Anywhere you wanna go. Can you tell me
baby, it's
alright?
Baby, can I call you if it's alright? Anywhere you are, baby, I catch flights. I'm loving the features that you were born with. Whenever you need love, trust me, I'm on it. Tell me, can you see you with me? Cause baby, I want you. I want you.
I like that. That was sexy for ladies' night. That was sexy for ladies' night.
You want to drink a whole bottle of Alize?
You so ghetto.
And is, honey.
Make you just want to put your feet up and take your tracks out.
Right? Wow, and drink a whole
or
bottle
glue them
of
back
hustles.
In. Maybe that hair is new. And we're being ridiculous. Anyway, me and Elle, Latasha and Elle, have some lists to get into. I've been thinking about some stuff while we had the week off from our last episode. So there was a YouTube thing going on a few weeks back, and it was trending, and it's called 5 Things I'm Not Here For. Things that you just don't have the time for, things that you're not investing your energy in, things that don't make any sense and you want them to go away. So here are the 5 things that I am not here for. First and foremost, I am not here for Beyonce's Instagram. Now, before y'all go cutting me up and punching me in my face and spamming me with all the Beyonce stans.
I will. Can you share your torch
No, I don't want to share her torch.
No, Latasha.
I'm sorry.
I'm agreeing with you.
Oh, okay, because I do
Let's
love Beyonce.
Share a torch and burn down the house on this topic, because as overrated as Beyonce is, all she does.
Gasp.
All she does. Copy when it comes to her Instagram.
Gasp. Right. I wasn't even going there with it, but please proceed.
I mean, yeah, I saw a couple of pictures. It's either her and her family, who we've seen dozens of times, and, you know, little baby Blue, who she keeps covered up like blanket, you know, Michael Jackson. I really wouldn't be surprised if I saw her dangling Blue over a balcony.
Okay, somehow. See, now you just took my whole topic and you went left. Beyonce, I wasn't even going to say that. I wasn't even going to do that.
I was. You knew I was going to do it.
But here's why I'm not here for Beyonce's Instagram. It's like, she's at the top of the throne. She's King B. We know this. We love her for it. But she's just not relatable. Instagram is to like show like personal moments. Where you're at. What you're doing. What you're drinking. Whatever is happening in your personal life. This is what we want to see on Instagram. King B, however, puts on this $1 million outfit. Of course, none of us can afford it. A dream of buying this stuff. Poses in front of a very basic wall each and every day and shows off her shoe, her shirt, and her face.
She could have paid. She could have got paid by Harper's Bazaar, and did the same thing. She's probably getting paid by Instagram, of course. She has to.
She don't need no Instagram money, but Instagram should be for her fans. She should. Miss Batty B is her Instagram handle. Like, we want to know like what you're actually doing. Who Beyonce actually is? Like,
I don't think the world will never know.
She's so unrelatable. And then on top of that, like you were saying, you think you're getting like these handwritten notes from Beyonce, something that actually came from her own King B mind,
copy
and she
paste.
Put it on paper for her fans.
Money,
no, they're always a quote from a poem or a song or something else. They're never something originated from Beyonce's self. And that drives me crazy. It's like she's a robot of a person. Like, Beyonce, soften up a little bit. Say something yourself. I know you're afraid of spelling. People have caught you on your spell check before. But that's not the point. We just want to know what's happening in your beautiful, blonde, light-skinned, brown-eyed head. Like, what's happening in there? We just want to know because we love you so much. That's where I was going with it. Elle, on the other hand, she don't like you too much, and I don't know why.
Me?
Oh, okay.
Me? So, I was about to say, because I clearly Beyonce.
So that was it. And I don't think.
My taxes.
And I wouldn't say, a lot of people do say, like, Beyonce, she just copying. But you know how many times have we made a Facebook status? We had a Frank Ocean lyric that we related to, so that was our Facebook status. Or.
But
or
that's different.
K. Michelle says something that resonated in your soul because your man just left you for
it's
some white
different.
Girl. How is it different?
Because Beyonce's like, oh, okay. I'm going to get my publicist. to go on Tumblr and copy paste and then put it on Instagram and make it sound halfway believable to my life, which has nothing to do with
and we
her
don't
life.
Know her life, and that's a problem that I got.
Oh, well,
anyway,
we know.
Continuing my list of five things I'm not here for. This isn't just about everybody else. This is actually about myself, this next one. I am not here for my own beer goggles. Okay, so this just happened to me too. Nights ago, I was out looking cute, getting me a little drinky drink. It was actually Wednesday night after the showcase. I went out, caught a drink, we caught up with some girls, and I'm not okay at drink number three. Like, I'm really not, and I think I'm cool and like soberish, but I'm not. So we go to the club, I'm feeling nice, we got a little hookah pipe, and some kid walks up to me, he goes, what do I gotta do to take you out? And I'm like, ooh, this is so much fun, da 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 da. Gave him my number. Then you sober up a little bit and the girls are getting ready to head out. And I look at him again because he's saying goodnight. And I was like, why? No. And I feel bad for the poor guy. He called me 2 days ago and he called me today. And I'm kind of ignoring him. Sorry.
The number one thing, even though this is ladies' night, I know there are men that are still in here thinking a whole bunch of shit like, you bitch. Because see, this girl.
I know.
They all have that happen to them. And so did many guys that are probably listening out. Like, damn, was that the situation with this girl that I've seen like probably like a week ago and she's not answering my phone calls? Or am I just a pervert? But I mean, either way it goes, we've all made mistakes.
Listen, Siri needs to have
when
my back.
We've been having that little drink, a little devil juice.
Siri just needs to have my back on like a whole new scale, because me and Siri do not see eye to eye. We never have. I never liked her. She never liked me. She calls me by the wrong name on purpose because she knows it gets me upset. But I need Siri to have like an optional feature that says like, curve this guy for me. Like, I need him to call, and she knows, feature. And she's like, Tosh, like, huh, girl, I got you. The number you have dialed is no longer in service. I'm sorry, Brandon. Please do not call back. And that was the kid's name. Yeah, so I'm not here for my own beer goggles. I think they're whack. I do love a drink, but sometimes they just get you caught in those situations that you don't want to be in.
It's like, I agree. And if that's the case, I'd rather just be safe and sit at home and drink. And act like Amy Winehouse. But besides
the dying?
Besides the OD.
Okay. Well,
I'm glad you agreed with me on that gruesome.
Here's point. Another thing that I am not here for. Reason number three. This is the third thing that I am not here for. It's the fake holla by guys. The fake holla. What is a fake holla? A fake holla is when you go out of your way to contact me, find me, get my information, finally give you a chance to like take this somewhere or do something, offer of a first date or anything, and you just disappear.
You do nothing.
Why couldn't you have just sat in your house and stared at me on Instagram like you usually do and just left me alone? Because that was your plan the entire time anyway. Like, I think it's just for sport.
It's like catfish. It's like the new show on MTV where you finally probably get to meet your mate after just staring at them on a computer screen for so long.
I actually think it's the complete opposite. I think it's like a technological masturbation. It's like, I'm going to get here until I climax, which is getting her number, and then I'm done. Mine equals blown. You guys are welcome. You guys are freaking welcome.
So that just was the nut.
Mine equals blown. But that's what I'm not here for. If you are going to go out of your way and send me all these messages and ask for my number and want to know me, and then I actually give you that opportunity and then you disappear, just don't. If I could just say that, just don't do that. It's really annoying.
It makes Latasha feel a certain type of way, which is why
it makes me feel annoyed.
You are on her list. You know who you are.
And then what I curl this weave up and take another Instagram and put a Valencia filter and make you real upset because now you ain't got a chance no more. Anyway, ladies' night, what's up? And then
I can't deal with it. I need a drink.
Hair, drink. Yo, all right, Juzz Roc The Mic fans, they always got a bottle here for us. It's our first ladies' night, and we are going in this dry. You understand? We are going in this unlubricated.
That's all I want to do right now.
This is me sober.
Honestly, the both of us.
No drinks for ladies' night. No, like, little Cosmo in a bag or nothing. Like, the love that these guys got for us right now,
dude. You might as
well
have gotten that guy that keeps calling you.
I should call up Brandon on air and see what's up.
What's up with the Alizé?
Well, here's the fourth thing that I'm not here for. Women. Why do we hate each other so much? Matter of fact, why do y'all hate me so much? I had two instances this past week where I literally walked in, spoke, and a woman was just fuming in attitude and hatred, like fuming, just so angry at me and gave me the biggest attitude. And I don't understand where it comes from, and I wish we would not do that to each other. Like, on some real, real, real stuff, yeah. I have to tell us, and it's usually, unfortunately, Black women. Like,
you gotta empower each other. Yeah, I mean, like, have you ever seen, I know you girls watch BET, My Black is Beautiful,
Black Girls Rock,
like, all, like,
Your Girl
now.
Is on Fire, like, all these things to uplift yourself. I hope you guys aren't on fire, but all these things to uplift yourself, and you see a fellow woman of color and you're so angry. And we really have to,
it starts within yourself. Like, if a woman is just not comfortable with herself and sees another woman of, you know, of stature, they just come in and walk into the room and you know that, or it's just like, whoa, you know, as probably Latasha does all the time, a woman will feel a type of way. She would. She'll feel a type of way. But yeah, it's all about, it starts within you. Just like, and just another thing, just kill them with kindness. Like, eventually, the little rawr, the little dinosaur will turn into a little puppy dog eventually. Like, it's just, it's you, I mean, because if you feed fire with fire, it's just going to be one big ass burnt down house, and you don't want to end up like Left Eye.
Wow, two deaths from L today. We're just going there.
No, I didn't mean about the death part. I was just talking about her.
Actually,
her,
three, because you said Michael Jackson too. You got something against the legends, though? You want to get it off your chest? You
miss, I wish them? They didn't. Yes, I missed them a lot. I missed them so much.
I'm just saying, it's a lose-lose situation.
You cheated us!
It's a lose-lose situation, because if I do walk up to a stranger, a woman that I don't know, and I say, wow, you look really nice today, or I love your hair or something, everybody gets so defensive, especially in New York. It's like, why is this girl talking to me? Like, don't ask me where I got my hair from. Don't ask me where I got my Ruby Woo from.
Well, you know what? Take me. That statement right there, I do agree from, like, with, that's just so, like, why would you ask? Woo girl, and then in front of probably like a big crowd of people, like, woo girl, what beauty supply store did you get your hair from? All cross-eyed and everything. Woo girl, like,
especially when you be trying to front act like your hair is natural and somebody ask you where you got your hair from, now that just kills your whole mood.
I'd be like, I don't want to try,
don't
tell,
ooh,
you,
ooh.
Like, I'm going,
I was about to plead natural. I was going to have to. She was trying it.
Oh no, not these. No, it's mine. I bought
get
it.
Out
hello.
Here.
Wasn't going to let you plead natural next to me. All right, here is the
it's
final.
Natural,
we've
natural,
come to the final final thing that I am not here for. It's the final on the list. Hello. Remember when we used to have the kids coming down the train asking for money, selling candy because they had to support their basketball team? A basketball team we've never heard of, seen. Anyway.
I just be wanting some M&Ms. Some
I skills. Am not here for the breakdancers. Every time you're always humping me in my face, you're almost kicking me in my chin. I'm trying to read my book. You guys are clapping, telling me to sit up, get down, give me a dollar, go over there. Excuse me, I need this pole. You don't need this pole. The train is crowded. I'm trying to get to Juzz Roc The Mic so I can get on air, and you're kicking me in the face, and now I'm unsturdy because you need to do a backflip.
You got
this
a big old bruise on your forehead.
No, and I don't know. And I'm glad you're not slinging rocks in the streets. I'm glad you chose another lane to earn money, but
you got to think a little bit harder, honey. Think a little bit harder about the ideas.
Who knew so many black kids could dance?
Really?
Every train, it's a different group. It's like, is there like a secret meeting? Like, the first rule about breakdancing is you don't talk about breakdancing, but you just show up and everybody knows,
right,
how to breakdance.
And
on
when
the train,
you see them coming with their mental sweatsuits matching, and it's like, oh, I already know what's up. Maybe I need to go to another car immediately.
And some of them got their shirts off and they way too young for me to be looking, so now I'm uncomfortable. It's like, I shouldn't be looking at that. Is that... And now I am. And now my Hunger Games is all thrown off and I can't read my book. I'm lost. And I don't have a dollar for you because
she's
I only carry my debit credit
looking.
Card. And now I feel guilty inside. So I'm not here
guilty
for you.
Guilty for looking at underage chests, Twitter chests.
You guys cause me too much emotional confusion. I just don't know how to feel. So those are all the things that I am not here for. We do have more lists coming up, but do we want to get back into some more music? Hopefully Chemistry wrote me a bigger note so I could read it.
Page by page.
We
a letter
are getting
by
into
page.
My girl, Miss Lydia Caesar, who performed at the Juzz Roc The Mic Showcase. This is her latest single called St. Louis from her mixtape, which is out now, called Caesar.
He has shown the lights of the town. His smile lifts me up when I'm down. First saw him on a summer night. Knew that moment would change my life. I fell in love with the way that he said, baby, baby, yeah. He told me that understands. He ain't afraid to say, baby, 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 I need you. I need him too. I'd kiss every mile that brought him my way. St. Louis, I love you. You seem the perfect.
Down, bang, bang, I hit the ground, bang, bang, my nigga shot me down.
Spitting out blood and shit, thought it was all love and shit. Till the truth hit my jaw, quench from my hurt. He thirst for it all and smile bright as the world turned to my jury. Hands ain't me, now the pain becomes a fury. I see the greed, hope it takes you to your knees. Let Jesus please show what he's into me. On this blaze of glory like the sound was from Neptune. He made this for me so I know I'm special. I try to be humble, but now I'm disgruntled. You hunted for my weak spots, now I will hunt you. Switching roles and it's not on no sex shit. I am a business, your host, so you need to respect it. And they can say whatever they they want, but all I hear is creeping cause you pussy from the front. And when I say pussy, I mean these little niggas. And when I say niggas, I mean these sus figures. Frontin' like you my nigga, but my niggas though, they been ready for the pick and roll. I trick them with the trigger flow. These niggas is the pitiful, I'm screaming Figaro. Sending while I'm spitting cause the mode I'm fitting is a smooth criminal. Like Fiona, like Eve, ate that apple. And late in the world, and watch how they blast you. I pass you, but I ain't have to be this bigger person, even though I'm hurting. You was my brother, but without I am curtain. Lost in the numbers, every song I am churching. Lord, forgive me, smoking a Jeffrey, peeling the off the heavy, so it's all. And it's. And I won't share your name, cause that would be unfair. My brother had me spitting out blood and shit. Thought it was all love and shit. Well, I guess you didn't know the bitch. Try not to judge a book by its look. Know this fucking soul will not have a hook. I'm telling you the story of a crook, of many crooks, of many men who wish death upon me. I speak to blind, so now they can see. You ain't never known me, you probably never will. The life story probably give the boogeyman the chill. So please chill, cause I'm the new deal. Trickling up the victor stairwell. I see you from the top. Why you still in fucking hell? No grudges though.
How dope was that track? That was LA spitting out blood. LA, girl. It's been a minute, so where you at? Holla at me. On a musical level, of course. Business, guys. I know Baby Girl was here last week just repping for all the lesbians. Shout out to all the lesbians, but LA, we just talking business, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, we are getting ready to make a Juzz Roc The Mic Valentine's Day mixtape, February 14, 2013. Any artist that's interested in donating their baby making music to our Juzz Roc The Mic Valentine's Day mixtape, hit us up. Send in your tracks to jrtmradio@gmail.com or justrockthemic@gmail.com. We have a million emails. Pick one. Send in your tracks. We want a lot of you guys a part of it as much as possible. Deadline to send in tracks is January 15th.
Yes, and I have a list of my own. My list is probably not going to be as long, because I just think off the top of my head.
You're just by a whim, L. Just right. by the skirt of your panties, little guy.
But you know, the year's almost over. Shoot, I as of today, I kind of probably almost didn't know that it was December. But
it's the last month of 2012.
Right, the last month. And I've just been, you know, recapping the whole year. And I'm like, yo, there's just some things that people really have, like, been sleeping on. Like, just, and by that meaning, they haven't really just paid enough attention to, or the people or topic has just hasn't got enough accreditation. So.
Did you just say accreditation?
Yes.
I like that. I like that.
Number one.
She educated, so she could do it.
Yeah, I'm just playing. But anyway, all right, you better Joe Clark it. But Jhené Aiko. Did I say that right?
No. She's talking about the cute little half Asian, half black Jhené Aiko
all the time, and I hate to pronounce her name because of that reason. Embarrassment. If Jhené, I was a lighter complexion, my cheeks would be red. I'm sorry, boo-boo, if you are kind of listening to this
Jhené
show.
Jhené is the black side, the little black French side, and then Aiko is the, I think, Korean.
Yes, let me give you, like, a summary. Well, Jhené, she came out probably around, like, the time of B2K. She was on the same label as them and put out a few songs and was, like, really never, like, recognized for it because it was kind of like basic, you know. She was a really pretty girl but trying to put out, you know, music, so she had to like leave for like a few years, had a baby with the producer, so she had to eat. She grew up and she came back out with a totally different sound, and her voice is just soothing. I can't even explain her voice. Like it's a really pretty falsetto-y voice,
a
and she talks
billowy little melodic voice. She right. has.
And she just speaks real shit, like relationship wise things, like out of the box relationship type things, and you know, just trying to live. And her last like mixtape was Sailing Souls apostrophe on the S, and which basically talks about like her basically trying to eat and what's been going on with her in the music industry as an underground artist, which the term Sailing Souls comes from. But she's a really cool chick. Her and actually her sister Mila J, which they were in a group together a long, long time ago too. Her stage name is Japalonia.
Don't ask
me. Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Don't ask me why. Don't yell at me. I didn't make up the name. Didn't come up with the name.
That sounds like a magical location.
Japalonia. It does.
It sounds like you open a closet and
you
fall
into
Japalonia. It
sounds like Prince's girlfriend dropped the J. Prince's ex, Apollonia.
Wow. I feel dreamy. I want to go to Japalonia.
Right. You would with the music she puts out too. It's kind of similar to Janae's, but it's also kind of the same. So I was like, why don't you just duo up, you know, and just make your own little group.
I see Janae as a solo,
but her sister's pretty much like joined at the hip, like kind of twinish. So it wouldn't matter. They're putting out different music. I mean, it's the same music, different person, same womb they came from. Might as well, you know. They tried it before, it kind of, you know, didn't work because of the time frame, time period, and the stuff they was putting out, which was what the label wanted them to put out. So I think it'll work.
Two member groups are annoying to me.
Like,
it's like
what? Like, what, like, do you mean?
It's like Nina Scott's two ass harmonies. Like, you need a third or a fourth to be a group. That two, I don't like that. Like, I find that so annoying. You might as well just be by yourself. Two-person group is like, you really want to be a solo artist, but you're scared, so you kind of got this guy here next to you just so you can kind of get a little, like, backing. But you might as well just be by yourself.
I don't feel that way about, like, OutKast, and they are freaking...
They're not singers. Awesome. They're not singers. There's no harmony in OutKast. That's just you spit, I spit, you spit, I spit. This is like singers are just like, you take the high note and I'm gonna take the low note, girl. Okay, ready, go. Hey. And then it's just like, girl.
I happen to actually...
Y'all need a third and fourth member. Y'all better put up on Craigslist and look for somebody else.
Big ups to Flowetry. I still listen to your shit.
Oh, you got me on that one.
I'm sorry, point for but I can't. I can't. I was
point
like,
for L.
But number two,
still a rapper. That's still a rapper singer though. So you get half a point.
Whatever, Latasha.
Because Marsha be harmonizing by her damn self.
Numero dos. We're moving on now.
All right.
I think you can take this one because you know this one. This topic that we've been sleeping on, because I have been sleeping on this topic myself. Awkward Black Girl.
Oh, that's the Awkward Black Girl is a series on YouTube that was started by Issa Rae, who's an actress, and she is hilarious. She has these YouTube ideas and web series. So one is called Ratchet Piece Theater, and her last episode is about this trio singing group. They're not singers, they're rappers. They're from the South, and they rap about their pride in being prostitutes. And their chorus is something like, I don't need to rap, I'm just selling beep. And that was the chorus. So they all get on, talk about how sexy they are, and it's like two big girls and one small girl. And Issa Rae just went in on like this new prostitute rap trio that are like busting it wide open on YouTube in a green screen. So it's really funny. And then her series, Awkward Black Girl, she's just literally the most awkward black woman you've ever seen, put in these random situations. And it's she is
story of
hilarious.
My life.
Hilarious. She is hilarious. She is hilarious. Her ringtone, she's in her web series, she's like a rapper. She wants to be a rapper. She's a rapper in her head. Mm-hmm. So on her ringtone on her phone, when it rings on the web series, it goes, take my panties off, boy, take these panties off. And every time my phone rings, you hear her rapping that on her. It's like things like that is just really stupidly funny. It's so
good. It's in subconsciousness
that
the things that she does. And I think I like shows like that. I really would like to watch that.
Don't
like,
sleep on that. Y'all got to watch Awkward Black Girl. That's really funny.
Okay, numero Chris. Okay, we all know the members of YMCMB.
Not all of them. There's a lot of them.
Exactly. Oh, okay. This is my point. This is what we're about to be sleeping while we're sleeping on them. Corey Guns. Okay. I feel like Lil Wayne and Damn are hiding Corey Guns in like a little pocket, special compartment, just in case everything goes wrong and fails and no one likes Nicki Minaj's clown hair anymore, and everyone starts to agree more that Drake's becoming too sensitive and keeps crying all the time. Corey Guns is just like the parachute when you fly out of the plane, the emergency parachute, because I don't understand how many people have been sleeping on this guy. I've heard a couple of his freestyles. My brother actually put me on, and so he was like, hey, come here, listen to these YouTube videos, like him like freestyling off of Eminem tracks. When I say that him and Eminem can actually make a second 8 Mile and possibly go head to head, it's that series. I think so.
Uh-oh.
Like, chemistry's looking at me like, you bitch, no the fuck. the fuck you thought in your life. But of course, I mean, but for the fact that Corey Guns can actually stand his own with these like these freestyles, him going, he made literally the hairs on my
chinny chin chin.
See, you know what, I don't think no one knew about that. See, I use Nair sometimes, but you know,
I got you today. You got you hairless, okay, on that chinny chin chin.
Okay.
Oh, you look beautiful today. Did I tell you that?
Oh, you
get it, girl.
But he literally, like, his goosebumps, like his with every, he just hit every bar on point from beginning to end, and when the music stopped, he kept going. He had everybody in the studio like, oh my god, give me more. Oh, is this nigga serious? Like, it's wonderful. It's like a breath of fresh air for like artists to just come out and just show their own, everything that they have and who they are, and that's what they're missing. And I'm like, why? Or like, y'all niggas, Lil Wayne, little Noop Noop Gouda Gouda, all y'all, come on, just step to the side, just let him take the lead, just let him not put out no shitty album where he has to hold back because of the label either. Some just show him. You can even put out a mixtape. I bet you everybody will eat it up. That's what I want to see. I don't want to, we shall not sleep on Corey Guns anymore.
All right, and I guess I was sleeping because I haven't heard from him.
Listen, everybody, listen to some of his YouTube freestyles.
But I mean, it's hard.
Fire.
I feel like it's hard for rappers to be themselves if they want to go mainstream, which is why we lost Lil Wayne and we lost Nicki, and they're just completely gone. It's just because, like, bringing it back to, I guess, Jhené Aiko, who she named his tape after, is like, selling your soul, not selling your soul.
Yes.
So they sell out just to appeal to everybody, but they're hardcore, they're number one, right, fans. They lose. I don't want to see the commercial parts, right, of them. So Corey Guns, I guess we're rooting, yes, for you.
Please.
And else we can, you can't let us down on that one now.
Right. Come out and own and be yourself. Own you.
What else we sleeping on in 2012?
Okay, the last one, because I was too lazy to make a fifth one. Numero cuatro. Hurricane Sandy. You know all of our asses slept on that.
I did.
Everybody.
You could check my tweets. I was like, here we go again with this fake old hurricane. Let me just turn up the cable and put my feet up. Thank God I got a day off of work.
And me, personally, coming from going to school in Alabama, we had hurricanes every week like it was nothing. People running in burrow holes and underground and under like in steel houses underground that they probably had, you know, the rich people, by the way. But they sat there and there was hurricanes back to back to back. So I'm coming up here, I'm like, New York, hurricane? Nigga, I'm home. This is nothing. Come on. I just left that. Please. And all of a sudden, wind started picking up. Rain started dropping a little harder than usual. I saw a person fly away past my window, no lie. And I was like, oh no. I know y'all have a basement. Grandma. I had to call her. I'm like,
basement's flood, girl. You're running the wrong way.
I know, but I don't know where God knows.
You would not have survived.
I'm one black person. I could swim.
Oh, you're from an island, right?
No, I just saw Titanic a lot. I know how to climb on furniture.
Okay.
So I could survive that way.
I don't have no furniture that float like that, so.
But yeah, like a lot of people were really surprised, and you know, the reconstruction still continues with Sandy. And you know, another thing I thought about, Red Cross is mentioned a lot when natural disasters first occur, and famine, and you know, a lot of, you know, serious issues dealing with the earth. But a few weeks pass, silence, quiet. No Red Cross, no mentions of Red Cross.
Red Cross bounced on them?
No more donations. No more, like, I guess the donations are slowing down. The only thing, they're still, you know, talking about it, like, with restoring the shore and, you know, in Jersey and everything like that. And, you know, some artists are still coming out and, like, hey, you know, still, you know, Sandy still occurred. There's still recovery that needs to be done. But it happens. I've noticed that with every natural disaster that's happened with the tsunami, everything, like, Haiti, you know, and things, and there's still a lot of reconstruction to be done in Haiti, and it, like, a lot, probably going to be like years worth. And just don't forget about, like,
it's always a trend up here. It's always a trend. It's like, this is what we're paying attention to right now until something else happens or it gets too old for media, and then we just kind of slowly stop worrying about it,
just because
we're good, and that's just it.
Yeah, just don't forget. Like, I mean, whatever you can to help, just, you know, help Red Cross, FEMA. Yeah, right. But
I don't know. There's a lot of complaints about FEMA. They say they never around. So if you're a part of FEMA, man, y'all got to step it up. You know what I kind of don't like? I don't like when celebrities turn a natural disaster into a press opportunity.
Exactly.
Like, if you're going to help people because you have money and time, absolutely do that. But for you to bring a camera along or give a little peep to the paparazzi so they magically appear when you're helping out, it just kind of takes away the merit from what you're doing. It's like, you're smiling for the cameras, and who are you, or what are you really there for?
Right.
But
like, this new commercial, like the new commercial for it comes on MTV a lot. See, that's how much I really don't want to pay attention to celebrities and what they have to say, except Bono. Bono is like a genius when it comes to trying to find relief for things that have disasters, AIDS, like gathering up concerts with millions and billions of people. Bono is that dude. You need help, you're starving, and is floating away in a tsunami, Bono is that guy.
He will help Superman. You. He will make a t-shirt. He will make a song. He would throw a concert. He would take over YouTube. He would take over your mama's plate. He would do everything possible to make sure you and all your black people are okay. Oh, he loves black folk. Yes, he does. Oh, that's some news reporter tease. I like that. Tonight on Channel 11, Juzz Roc The Mic takes over the world. Anyway, we're about to get into some new music, and I hope it's still some sexy for ladies' night. Ooh, ooh. This is VMS, which stands for Voice Music Sounds, and this is some songs of his new mixtape, Turn My Mic On, which was released on natpiff.com. Check out Go Crazy and Comfort Zone.
Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy, wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy,
I'm on the road to the riches. I drove here with bitches. Gold on my wrists, cuts, no stitches. Strong for the snitches, flow so ridiculous. No homo, don't give a fuck like I'm dickless. Coke for the snitches, low in them trenches. Dower for the Dutch. switches, drove with the swishes. I'm Rosemont popping, you so cold sipping. Swag past pimping, we so so different. Bag bad chicks, shake that crazy ass. With a Nicki butt, but her face Stacey Dash. Work girl, make the cash. Give them thumbs up like I held a cab. Brains in the whip, call it smart car. Call me Candyman, gave her the Mars ball. Go crazy with that cake, shake it porn star. Make it clap, clap, bring it back like an encore.
Make it bounce, girl. Make it bounce, girl. Dip it low, girl. Dip it low, girl. Bring it back, girl. Bring it back, girl. Make it clap, girl. Make it clap, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it.
I can make it wetter than the rain dance. Pipe game retarded like I'm Rain Man. Money in the air, watch it rain, man. Say it was the liquor when there's nobody to blame, man. Wanna know what we about? You're not rocking with the best, and I ain't even need a drop. Make the classy girl strip, homie, and I don't need a pop. Many niggas cuff it, ho, so we no longer needin' cops. Don't need ID and VIP, we chillin' in the back. Shorty's flocking in the team because they see me tossing racks. She make that booty clap.
Dip it low, girl. Dip it low, girl. Bring it back, girl. Bring it back, girl. Make it clap, girl. Make it clap, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it.
Go crazy. Make that ass twerk.
Chicks obsessed and can't let go. My older chick, she too much of X and O's. But you my 38, you special. Believe that, headaches, I don't need that. Addicted to your style, and I think your boy just relapsed. It's time, girl, step in my zone. Relax with you, think the bubble and the tubs full. Discussions over wine, trust we keep them cups full. And when a nigga stress, yes, you keep my blunts raw. You like this, I like that. Reminiscing about those days in the nightcaps. Gave you crazy loving, knew you might snap. Remembering those times got me feeling like I might jack. She asked me will I leave when the night's gone. I told her she my future, turn the lights on.
I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone.
Relax your mind, I exercise your interest. Make it work out, I'm like a Planet Fitness visit. Be my miss or mistress, it's a hit or miss. Just know that once I hit and dismiss, you're gonna miss it. I'm no lovey-dovey, but I love when honey hugs me. Swear you in a hurry, bro, cause every time you rush to touch me. Single like the one of money, but treat me like a hubby. Like an undercover cop, you wanna lock and cuff me. Damn that cutty cuff me, man it got me fiending. Damn it got me fiending, I'm your cutty's cutty. We ain't friends, more than friends, call it cutty buddies. I'm a player and I crush, I rip big one for dummies. Got a shower fetish, streets are rubber ducky. bathtub, sex is lovely, swear to God I'm lucky. She my Rubik's Cube, twist, I hope I make it match. I'm your nookie cookie monster, hug my favorite batch.
I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone.
Let me be your comfort zone, similar to what's at home. Let me do it right, cause the mother brothers do it wrong. You inspired me just to write the lines I do in songs. I'm the boss, but still you hire me. All my lows are gone.
Cups got us both feeling over nice. Camel toe, fat your lips looking like an overbite. No interruptions, let me turn off my phone. So baby girl, come in and just step in my zone.
I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone. I just wanna let you know, you ain't gotta be alone. Step into my comfort zone.
All right, that was Comfort Zone by VMS. Shout out to him. We're going to have to make this part of the show a little more sexy since it's ladies' night.
Word.
Don't we? Oh, okay. Ow. So, Elle, I'm going to ask you some questions. I'm going to ask you some questions. And ladies, please feel free to call.
Too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. Love.
You know I have to do it every time. Hey. That's just a sexy dance. For y'all who's streaming online, this is my sexy dance. We call this the kitty cat. Ladies, y'all gotta call us up and talk to us. We get into some sexy mode. Our number is 718-369-0411. So Elle, I'm gonna ask you some questions and you have to answer as honestly as possible.
I shall.
All right.
You know, I never all disappoint. Right.
So you have to tell me, if these guys weren't famous, would you mess with them? Would you hook up with these guys if they were not famous?
Sure.
Would they naturally get your groins? Get your groins moist?
Tender and tender.
Tender lemon. All right. First guy is Waka Flocka.
Okay, I cannot get past the beer belly. He's okay in the face.
You never mess with the beer belly.
If I did mess with him, I'm just telling you, he would scare the shit out of me with the Tourette that he has, probably while things were going on.
A-B-F-U-C-K.
I don't know about that.
Could you imagine the lights down low, candles going, Waka Flocka, he just slide the panties off, and then he gets on top and he goes, bop, bop, bop.
next person, please, Lord Jesus.
Waka Flocka, you get a no. Maybe if he was on the Ave, I think he'd get some play, some Jamaica Avenue action.
Queens, shut out.
Here's
those Queens girls.
A lot of them, like, you know. Here's another guy. 91. He had plenty of beautiful women vying for his attention, affection, love, and care. Would this guy get it if he was not famous? Biggie Smalls.
I would be scared.
You wanna know why? You're so scared of everybody. She's tiny, y'all. Elle is very small,
yeah,
actually.
That's exactly the point. Like, he might crush the shit out of me. I'd always have to be on top.
If you've seen the movie, but, you know Big don't get on top.
Yeah, I know, but one night he might, I don't know. It's just a movie. You don't know what happened in real life.
This soundtrack is actually making me very uncomfortable. Thank you. I just That soundtrack just makes you,
in the background, like
that beat, like it reminds me of someone just leering at you from the corner of the train, just kind of his hand is like moving up under his jacket. Right. Stevie J, little mouse face. That's what that feels like. Somebody just breathing on the back of your neck in a party. It's creeping. Right. Ew, that's what that song makes me feel like. So we thank you. Thank you so much, 8, for changing that.
But Biggie, yo, he had that talk though. He had that game. Like if he got Little Kim, he can get everybody, right?
I mean, is Little Kim a standard?
Exactamundo. Next person.
All right. This man has got a lot of money and swag and just poops diamonds. Baby from YMCMB. Would he get the draws if he was not famous?
Why are you not pointing out people that I would actually give the business to? Because everybody has been a fail so far, Latasha. Come on.
That's the point. That's the point. Because these guys are getting everybody because they got a lot of money and they on TV. Like, when we
I don't care. I know baby got that Donald Trump money. I'm picky. I guess I'm okay. A very picky girl. I'm extra... Because I tell regular scrubs, if you were Donald Trump, you would not get the business. So I guess if baby was just a regular person.
The comb over don't get you going?
Not even a Patrick Star on his head. On baby, to be exact. Donald Trump, I don't know. I might like to run my fingers through it. But when I lift my fingers up, I better not see a toupee in between my fingers. That's all I have to say about
still
that.
Still attached.
One. Still attached, yes.
Okay, this next guy is... Really, he has become the sex symbol of R&B. Smash if it wasn't famous, Trey Songz.
Yeah, but
that was quick.
I said but. I had to add that.
She wasted no time. First of all, Trey Songz is, I got dibs. Okay?
No, you can have him because like him being, okay, listen, I want Trey Songz back when he was rocking the braids, still talking about just gotta make it.
Oh,
but he better not sing in my ear because his voice is, I don't like his songs. He's a little like, don't sing.
You don't want
ear.
Him yodeling in your ear?
No, I don't want the yodels in my ear at all. I don't want, yeah, I don't want none of that. No, I will stop. I would be like, listen, it's been real, it's been fun. But it ain't been real fun. I have to. Mm-mm.
How you want him back in his scrawny days, but you don't want him now?
Because if it wasn't what, because he's not evolved. Famous. That's exactly the point, though, Latasha. Like the evolution's a little faggish to me now.
Oh, God! Are you serious?
Sorry, it's a little faggish. I'm sorry, but no, the little baby. The first picture I saw, he had on that little fur jacket, whatever the fuck it was, and the little the oil down baby oil. And he's just,
I think
you're
talking about the picture I posted on Instagram.
I didn't see that one, but it might be the same one.
It was,
honey.
National Boyfriend Day on Instagram, and she's single, so I posted up a pic of what my boyfriend in my head is, and that was Trey Songz greased up with a fur on, with a little belly hair hanging out from the jeans, curled up.
It's a little. I'm gonna need to get back to
Smash Latasha, if he fail. Wasn't famous. Next guy, Ray J.
I'd have to ask if he wasn't famous. He would be all out in the open, because you already know that he's kind of halfway out in the open about like who he's with, and he doesn't care who he's banging, obviously. And this is with any guy, I'd have to check behind the TV, video. Is there any video cameras, VCRs? What you doing with that camera? Oh, it's just the phone, baby. I just wanna, you know, take. You know, have some us time. I thought that's me and you, not me, you, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, shots. No, son, I can't do. Like, he's really out open with his relationships. And I just feel like if he wasn't famous, it'll be out open probably in the streets. And that kind of guy's like whack to me.
He seems like the guy who's trying to find a click, and nobody quite wants him around, but it's kind of like, well, you're, you know, you could hang out with us, Ray J. I'm not here for the dark circles at his eyes and like little neediness for friends. Like, I just don't know where he fits in. He doesn't know where he fits in. So Ray J would get a pass if he wasn't famous. Last but not least, and I already know the answer to this, but this is just funny to bring up. Mm-hmm. Smash if he wasn't famous. Flavor,
I knew it. Because I was going to give it to you if you didn't give it to me. I hate you, Latasha. I hate you. Yo, I couldn't even imagine being on this show. These girls, I was flabbergasted. It was ludicrous. It really was. The way these girls was just
lining
on, just,
up.
Oh, I want me a piece of burnt chocolate. Oh, I gotta have it. It's like you're all going after a piece of beef jerky, the last piece of beef jerky in the bag. You guys are all starving on a desert island.
I'm
not about to answer that question because you already know it is what it is.
I feel like sleeping with Flav, his skin would soak up all
like
of the moisture out of you. And I feel like you'd wake up with scabs and your feet would be all cut up.
And cold.
It'd be like fried chicken skin in between the sheets from whatever he was eating from before. Like, you just don't know.
Because, you know, he used to love that chicken. I'm talking about the quarter chicken. Not the little chicken wings. The actual whole quarters of the chicken all
just
fried.
Just the skin still, like, in the sheets. Like, he forgot to throw it away or clean up. And you just waking up.
And the girls loved it.
I couldn't imagine the things The things that ladies do for fame. The people that I hate seeing kiss on TV is definitely Flavor Flav.
And anybody.
For some reason.
Or himself.
And for some reason, Sean Wayans. Like, when I was watching The Wayans Brother, and Sean Wayans he was supposed to be the sexy one and always had a girlfriend or whatever. And, like,
he
has to kiss
them. Oh, I always
beg to
differ. I always thought he was the gay one.
Well, yeah.
He was a disco dancer.
Yes, God. Yes, he was. Well, we're going to keep up this whole sexiness. Do we want to get into some more music, or did you want to ask me some questions, Elle?
I might throw it back at you. I'm not too sure, but we'll get into some music first. I might throw it back, twerk it back at you.
All right, we're going to get into J Pounds. We're failing right now. Trying to get into some music. Tonight by J Pounds.
We are both blind. It's like the blind.
You was
the
covering
blind
up the
right
tonight
now
with the two fingers though.
I'm gonna type this. Damn you, Kendra.
You couldn't give me a clean sheet of paper.
You had to write it with all the other ones.
Streams don't vary, just my love, what it does tonight. call your bluff. I don't come with no tricks, no strings, don't worry. Just wanna put it down. This may take a while, no need to rush. Just you and me, no stopping us. I don't come with no tricks, no strings, don't worry. Just wanna put it down tonight.
Remember what you heard first.
They say love.
I give exclusive.
Brings pain. But really, it's supposed to bring joy. But that same joy drive you insane. They tell you that the end is near. But really, they want you to fear. Living life without a care be the only thing that they truly fear. I told them I never fall short. Putting on my shorts, heading for the courts. Only plan to be number one. And know the future of rap, baby, it's just begun. Kings County is where they found me. Queens raised me, but L.I. will be where they crown me. Feel the devil around me, constantly he surround me. Bringing my past back, but I'm past that. He don't understand, he can't seem to grasp that. Guess I got the devil mad, he ain't get the last laugh. With my pen in the pad, up in the lab. Introducing my team, this is the regime. What up, Sash? What up, Bricks? What up, D-Money? What up, E? Money, what up, Cave? What up, K-Rock? Big C, I told you we aiming for the top. What up, Kid? What up, Jamie? That shit that happened with Sandy was crazy. Plenty people who are equal, they lost their home. Make you wanna take the fucking chrome, put it to your dome. Out you yelling, fuck the world, go leave it the hell alone. But we aiming for the throne, so we staying in the zone. With a smile on our face like Carmelo. It's an NY thing, we are hard fellows. From the suburbs, heading out to every ghetto. From the suburbs, heading out to every ghetto. Hoping that it eases the stress. In a world full of lies, shall the fuck the press. They got us all depressed. Who made the office? Yes, I'm riding in my resident. I got a black president. The only thing left to mention is after the election, what I'm projecting, perfection. No more unemployment, rejection. I got an appointment with success in. To be the best in, I'm never resting. And falling off the maps out of the question. Should I even say more?
You suckers know what we came for.
Diamonds.
Shine bright to the night. You and I, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I
It's for the ladies. Better Lord, y'all, in my lifetime.
For the ladies, even the ones I hate. Yeah, I still love the ones I hate it down till I make it. This for you.
For
and you. And you.
You
this
too.
This goes out to you. And you. And you. Yeah. This is for the ladies, even the ones I hate it. Yeah, I still love the ones I hate it down till I made it. This for you. And you. And you. This goes out to you.
It was getting to Latifah, Katrina, Kelly, and Nina. But now it's fucking with Isha. Had an ass like Serena. My girl Kim was my diva. Nothing could come between us. That's how I knew it was true love. And that's the only one that I tried. All the bitches say that I'm cold. I ain't got no time for them hoes. So just strip down to your toes. Let me beat that and get gone. Cause I'm grown and I'm on. And if you ain't heard it just bone before, then that just means you a silly hoe. Make your head go round like Mary. We go. Bitches be frontin' on when they wantin' my lovin'. They find a reason to hate me, be actin' grimy for nothing. Bitch, but I be on my grind though, rollin' up that Fronto. Through time you might blow on my dick. No disrespect for ladies, just have to keep it real. How can I make them sick when I give sex appeal? Sometimes I lost grip, I let these bitches slip. Try to keep them in my hand, but I made these whole drip.
For the ladies, even the ones I hated. Yeah, I still love the ones I had it down till I made it. This for you, and you, and you. This goes out to you, and you, and you. Yeah. This is for the ladies, even the ones I hated. Yeah, I still love the ones I had it down till I made it. This for you, and you, and you. This goes out to you, and you, and you.
They call me Hurricane, cause I ain't nothing simple. Stay blowing on these trees while I flood her temple. Natural disaster, I go faster, I cause an earthquake. Blow candles like it's your birthday, pour down the door cause it's Thursday. Can't say y'all all freeze, cause some of y'all unique. Simone and Nikki held it down for me on every street. Back in the day when I was flipping quarters, nickels, dimes. Leah and Amber used to bump my shit and learn my rhyme. So many years, so many days, so many hours. How many lives did I devour? I was a kid, fiending for power, always kept it 100, so you won't see no change. I caused a lot of grief, I'm sorry for your pain. I hope I helped you grow, instead of fall back. Some of y'all I cut off, but they just called back. Don't know where we gon' end up, just hope it ends well. I slide you to the team, and let my friends tell.
Even the ones I hate, yeah, I still love the ones I held it down till I made it. This for you, and you, and you. This goes out to you, and you, and you. Yeah, this is for the ladies, even the ones I hate. Yeah, I still love the ones I held it down till I made it. This for you, and you, and you. This goes out to you, and you, and you. Yeah.
All the pros all about the dough. She don't really care about you. She just trying to be seen.
She just trying to be seen.
Here lies a broken man, causing battle all because giving soul away. Idolized, pretended life.
With a star over there.
Yeah, she was holding it down for us. All right. Well, Latasha, since you got me that little list, I got a little list of my own. Since we're going to turn up the heat for our last little segment.
Ooh.
Caller.
Well, let's. What is your list about?
Are they on? Juzz Roc The Mic.
Hi, Tasha, it's me. I'm on the radio. Hi.
Oh, is this who I think it is?
It's me.
This is my friend. Come on.
Hi, everybody.
Hey.
I'm great. On. How are you? What are you doing?
I'm doing nothing, but I wanted to give a shout out to me because it's almost my birthday. Yay.
Yes, happy almost birthday to Kimon. Her birthday is coming up, and you sound like you're lounging right now. You're supposed to be tuned into Ladies Night on Juzz Roc The Mic, girl.
I'm about to be as soon as I finish my homework.
What a good kid. Look at you. Great. Just making it. Just making it in America. Just the way your family intended.
Great morals and values. Yes, I love
it. Thank you.
I love it a lot.
Well, Elle was just about to ask me some drilling questions since we're turning up the sexy. We're coming on to our last hour. Maybe she can ask you first so you can soften the blow.
Lord, I'll try. Okay.
So my little topic is, well, actually, is I also have a list of people who you think that, you know, you would do. Who you would give it to. But, you know, it's not guys. It's girls you would go gay for.
Oh, Lord.
You were talking to Miss...
What's a twist?
Miss Jamaican Christian here. So let's see her answers on this one.
Yeah, I don't know how this is going to turn out.
I'll try to be a good sport. Okay.
Okay. Question of the day. Who would you go gay for? She has a list.
I'll give you the first one because I really have to grill. I have to grill Latasha because she had gotten me earlier. If you were tuned in.
Okay.
If you remember that 70s show, Mila Kunis, the little rich girl, dark hair.
Yeah,
Honey, the Black Swan.
She, but no, she's a mag on Family Guy. No,
That's her cartoon character.
I'm sorry. No, I can't get past that.
You can't get jiggy with that cheat?
No, no thanks.
Okay.
Do you have anybody in mind that you would go gay for? Girl on girl.
Ew. No. Sorry.
She's blushing over there.
All right. Jesus forgives you. Come on. Jeez Louise. You want to give a shout out or say anything?
Shout out to every Sagittarius, December. Yay, go us.
We got some love in the studio for that one.
I got those.
It is Sag season. I don't know what you guys are about, but I guess you'll teach me. You'll continue
people, you know
to
that. And shout out to you for doing your thing on the radio. So proud of you. Kisses.
Thank you, Kiloko.
You're welcome.
I'd so go gay for you if Jesus wanted it, but guess not.
Maybe next lifetime.
Maybe on your birthday. You get a big booty hug.
Hey, hey, hey.
Thank you, boo, for calling me. Calling
okay,
us.
Love you.
Love you. See you later.
Bye.
We're already so gay. Right. This is why this doesn't gay. Even me and Kimon, like, we're
gay for everybody.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Numero dos.
Who would Latasha go gay for? Ella's giving me these options right now.
Would you go gay for Maya?
Hell no. Hell no. I am not here for Maya's weak singles, those ham hock thighs, those cankles, and that big ass calf.
Yikes.
No, thank you. Yikes. She looks like a plump lollipop with that big head and those curls. You know what? She actually has a very cute face. I'm not liking the new look, the new direction, what she's doing. I'm over Maya. I've been over her since it was all about her and Cisco. So.
Ooh. Jesus, I ain't hear that name Cisco in a long time.
Do you not know that I was Cisco's number one fan? Like, dead ass, I was Cisco's number one fan.
Unleash the Dragon was Cisco. If you guys, him and Drew Hill.
If you guys would like to archive me and see me hug Cisco so hard back when Free and AJ was the host of 106 in the Park, that was me. Blue sparkly guest shirt, white capris, thought I was doing it, new doobie rap, and I hugged the hell out of Cisco because I was his number one fan.
Wow.
Crying like a fool. Crying like a fool.
I will when I go home and be like, that's Latasha! Everybody check her out.
That was me. And I have the VHS at home too. Aww. As a keepsake.
Well,
so sorry, Maya. No Maya, but all Cisco.
Yikes. Right. She's going out of the limitations of the whole topic.
Right.
Girls. Girls, girls, girls.
Okay, no hetero,
girls,
no hetero.
Girls, girls, girls. Who is number three? who would Latasha go gay for? Latasha, would you go gay for Scarlett Johansson?
Yes!
Lord, we got a winner! We got a winner! Got a winner!
Go Scarlett! Go Scarlett!
We should tiggle bitties.
Oh, Scarlett. And you know what? I think that's what I like about her. Like, she's a white girl with a body. Like, her waist is tiny. She got a big butt, big boobs, really curvy, very cute, and very creative and talented. So, Scarlett Johansson. Absolutely.
So, you know I got to ask you this next question. And I think I know what your answer is going to be to this one. Ooh, my ring got caught in my shirt. Would you, Latasha, go gay for King B?
No. You know why? And my dad isn't listening. There was a picture of her on media takeout years ago, and she was performing in these little gold shorts, and she had a stripper pole. I think it was checkup on it she was doing, and her move was to get in front of the stripper pole, bust it wide open, but she didn't wear any underwear that night, so everyone got full front view of what that twang looked like, and I'm not interested.
Ooh.
At all. I'm not interested. And her teeth and her mouth, I don't want any part of. But you know what, she's beautiful, and I think she's beautiful to where I just want to look at her and admire her because she's so beautiful, but when it comes to sexually, I don't want that.
Jay, if you like it.
Ooh, Jay-Z. Now that's a dude, if he wasn't famous, would still, no. And I hear girls say all the time, like, Jay's so cute. He's not cute. You're attracted to his swag, his fame, his money, his aura. You're attracted to the Jay-Z-ness of Mr. Sean Carter. But that face in the morning broke.
Just imagine him like turning over like.
And just breathing that first morning breath, smile at you. No, God.
I need.
Sorry, Jay. She gotta be in love, son, cause that. Ooh, that's a tough phase.
Moving on. I'm sorry, Jay. Love you, V.
And Blue Kinda. Ivy starting to look like him instead of the mama. That's oof.
That's what everybody predicted. Swing and a miss. They put a hex out on the kids.
Let's swing not talk and
about,
a miss.
Let's not talk about people's children.
Okay, but I'm sorry.
Okay. Numero.
Just say it in
Cinco.
English.
Like, I'll do, say it a little English, bit in Spanish class.
Okay. Bye. Shout out to Rosetta Stone. Holla, that's my girl.
Right. Oprah.
Oh, that was the option.
Yeah, I just gave it to you.
I thought you were giving me like a YMCMB, like eating candy, nerds, like that. So I thought it was like that. So, okay. But Oprah, Latasha, is the one you that you want me on to.
Oprah.
Get no. Out of here.
Hell to the no. No. No.
You wouldn't go gay for your own network.
Nope. Did you see the picture of her and she had a sex scene with Terrence Howard? And
she's like smoking a cigarette. I want to keep it that way because I want my lunch to, every time a scene like that comes up with Oprah, I'm always eating. So I change the channel because I want my food to stay down in my stomach and not have to regurgitate it. That's all I would have to say.
Oprah,
about
that. No. I can't see her with the clothes off and no makeup on.
Last but not least.
Dun, dun, dun. Make it good, girl. I only went gay for one person.
You would go give for Rihanna.
Oh, absolutely. Yes. Yes.
I think we all would. I would. I think everyone would. Go ahead and play her song. Shangri-La. I'll roll up diamonds with your ass. I would roll up diamonds with your ass.
I would roll up diamonds on her ass.
Right.
And on her breast. Right. And on her back. And around her neck. And on her face.
Money shot?
Whoa. Too much? That's what Elle signed up for.
Oh. Yeah. I didn't receive the results that I wanted. But it's okay. It's okay.
Well, that was a fun game.
It was.
Who would you go gay for besides Rihanna?
Toni Braxton.
Oh.
In that deep voice. You can sing to me.
Do tell. Do tell.
Yes. And ever since, like, I guess that first
you
album.
You like that old
that
time.
Boomerang.
That legendary.
Yes, you got to. Oh. Who I would really, really have it twerk it for me. And she's older. Oh, way older. Shaka Khan.
You are one weird specimen of a weird.
I am weird. But
and
she,
I love every come nook on and cranny of it.
Shaka Khan, though.
To take that girdle off and twerk that red wig twerk all over it. Your bedroom.
Come on, you know you can do better when you take those teeth out your mouth, too. You know? We can get with it. If you hurt, you know, I could put some Bengay on you.
Bengay and sex is not, that's not hot.
Icy hot?
I can't do. Alright, let's move on.
But did you see the younger life. Photos of Shaka Khan back when she was with Rufus? Yes. My God. Like
a woman I know.
She was in her
history.
little feather headgear with the Indian. She was freaking gorgeous. And she has lost, like, you know, weight since. And if she's able to pull a 23-year-old boyfriend, man, way younger man, way young, to be her grandbaby.
Would she have gotten him if she wasn't famous?
Right. Right. I don't know. Moving on.
I don't know. Your options are so weird.
I know.
Oh. I don't know. Anyway, so I did have another topic, though. Kimo's giving us instructions. I don't know what he's saying. Okay. I did have something that I was actually curious about, because this has happened to me, and I know that I can be looked at as an effed up individual.
I think, I don't know. Does
please
Kimo
pass chemistry.
He really needs it.
Yes, we finally figured it out.
It's like a mouse trying to get to the end of the maze.
There is some,
the cheese.
There is some confusion behind the scenes that just rocked the mic. Bear with us. First Ladies Night. I'm excited about it. Anyway, Here we go. So I know I can be looked at as an effed up individual, but I would only be effed up if I didn't act out on my feelings about it. Now, years ago, you know, my friends are, there's some good looking girls, and as it should be, naturally, you would attract some good looking guys. So my friend had this, she's not my friend anymore, but
my friend,
no, give an applause for that. She is not my friend anymore. Jesus saved. Jesus saved. She had a hot boyfriend. I mean, this boy was hot. He was just tall and fit. He had a perfect smile, perfect little personality. He just cared about her so much. His teeth were beautiful. And like the first time I saw him, we all had to go after a club and eat together. He sat right across from me. And I had to look like, I had to force myself to not be a creeper. I wanted to stare at this boy all night. And by the end of the meal, I realized I was kind of crushing on my friend's man. That ain't right. I know it ain't right. You guys can call up and yell at me about it. I never did anything. I never acted on it. But, you know, it stays in the brain a little bit. Like,
we're only human. We're only human. And if you know, there's a, you know, and some girls are just like to the point where they're like, oh, I know she wore my man. She said he was cute a little too many times. Like, if you just really just keep it to yourself and be like, oh, okay. And it would even be more effed up if, say, when they, if they broke up, or if they did break up, and you would have just been like
scooting in, getting close, real close.
Hey, Jeremy, whatever your name is. So, are you still with so and so? What's her face?
Ella's putting a G on me. You gotta talk into the mic.
But yeah, so like it would be a even more effed up situation if you would have acted upon after the fact that it was over, which like I like had that experience. Like someone, like one of my, I guess, acquaintances, I mean, she was really never that great with me, and but we, you know, we were cool. She was a good person like to hang out with and talk to. There's a caller. But then, you know, she, in the end, when me and my ex broke up, she kind of acted upon it.
That actually was a personal story of my best friend. She saved her best friend's life. The girl got kicked out of her house. Ex-wife had nowhere to go, so my best friend took her in. The girl that she moved into her house saw her man, liked him. While living with her, waited for them to break up, and then started dating her boyfriend. Her friend that she saved her life started dating her man. And came back to her house after she finished sleeping with her ex-boyfriend. Came back into her house to live with her. If that's not charity, if that's not having a big heart,
sharing,
if that's not being touched by the Lord.
So we got a caller. Caller on the line. Juzz Roc The Mic. Oh, don't.
She wasn't about that life.
Oh, I think she thought we was referring to her. And maybe she wanted
like,
oh,
that sound like me. I can't do it.
I can't deal with it. Never mind. I'll call back later.
Gramps is asleep. You know, we haven't seen Gramps in 4 weeks. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks. Gramps has been gone.
I mean, he did you know, there's some things that were going on, you know, within life, everybody's life. But I guess this time he was supposed to come, but I don't know what happened this time. I can't vouch.
At least you reached out for him a little bit, but bottom line is I'm the new guy and I'm here.
Gramps.
We in here, sitting in your seat.
And I'm going to get running some Papachana lemonade and whatnot and sit it right here. No, actually, I'm going to get my own drink. I'm going to get some V8, I guess, because it's a women's drink. I don't know. I'm going to get some juice and I'm going to sit it right here and I'm going to be like, yeah, what you think? Like my bottle? You can't have it, especially if you're Gramps. Just playing Gramps. Come through. Where you at?
He's on a punishment. You can at least call in, son. Say hi. Say hi to your friends. But anyway, but you never looked at one of your girls, man, and was like, ooh.
Yeah, but I was in your situation and I never really acted upon it.
What did he look like? Give the details.
You ever seen... Okay, this was way back. Like, okay. Because this was like probably around maybe like the end of high school. And yeah, like me and my friends, we all went out. We went out bowling one night. And she brought her boyfriend along, like, you know, to come, like, chill. So we were just like, okay, cool.
It was
he
a threesome.
He came walking. No, it was that would have been an orgy because everybody was there and everybody was involved. And he came in through the door and it wasn't just me because we were all cool. It was like a whole clique of us. You know, in high school, we have our cliques. And we came in and we all turned around, all the girls. We were just like...
I saw your face and wow.
We all met in the bathroom, I guess, like while her and her boyfriend, you know, were chilling, and we would just let, and we was like, God damn, like, do you see this nigga? It was like a very younger version of Genuine mixed with, and Genuine back in the day to me, he was just fine. I'm talking about perfect cut, like chiseled. And perfect, like, hairline, perfect everything, like, got that good hair.
That had to been back in the day.
It was. He had that little S-curl going on. But, yeah, I mean, it is what it is.
Did you kind of hate on your friend a little bit? Just a little bit?
I had a little hate. I was like, you know what? You no good son of a... You know, you don't deserve...
You can't do it. I cannot.
Deserve it.
You know, we get that sometime, but...
But yeah, we're about to wrap it up soon.
Oh, I have to put my friend on blast.
Tiara
Lopez, who just tried to call in. It wasn't her fault though. It was Tiara Lopez who just tried to call in and talk to me and support. But she's at work, so she had to get back.
And we got that's why we got a second.
Do we have somebody else on the air? Somebody calling Juzz Roc The Mic Radio?
Yeah, man, it's Gramps.
Oh! We done put you on blast 4 weeks in a row, boo.
Yo, I'm dead. Better sleep with my clothes on, my nigga. That's just not funny.
Ooh, you so sound funny like shit, it. Though, the funny you sound like your breath still hot.
Yo, the funny shit, I had my hat on, like, all over my face, right? And I had some Spanish food. I'm dead ass eating
that sounds nasty.
Nah, that
we miss you.
Nah, that shit definitely hit me. And I fell asleep on a fucking chair. Like, my face is going crazy.
Who shot you? You are so black for that.
Oh, man. nah, what's up, y'all?
Yo, you tell us what's up. I haven't seen you in 4 weeks.
I tried to defend you.
What you been doing?
I tried.
Oh man, I've been MIA for a little while, but I'll be damn. Why the fuck did I go to sleep?
Well, listen, I actually have a question because I'm hearing from the studio that you sat next to me on the train and didn't say hi. Like you sat like right, not even like in the same car, but you sat like right next to me, like kneecap
yeah.
Playing,
oh,
and you ain't say nothing.
Sorry, yo. You dead ass walked on an up train like mad fast, right? You shut down and then you pull your book out. So I'm looking at you like, yo, is that Natasha? So I'm like, yo,
well, it definitely ain't Natasha. That's for first and foremost. Had you been at the studio, you would have remembered that.
Listen, I'm a little sleepy, so you gotta cut me some slack. I see me in the book, so I'm like.
Gramps,
oh, we gonna sit next to us. I sit next to you, right? I'm dead ass, like, saying, yo, what up to you? And all that. And the funny shit is a man saying,